Hello, I'm Laura Whitmore, and this is Mick. And today we brought the hot desk to the South Place Hotel to meet a Swedish pop sensation who promises never to forget us and is living the lush life. Zara Larsson. Mm-hmm. Willkommen to the hot desk.
Thank
you. How was that?
That was great.
It
was,
I kind of said really it in a creepy, good. Scary way, like I was a Bond.
No, I think you've practiced.
I mean, I may have been practicing. Yeah. welcome to the hot desk.
Thank you.
It's good to have you here.
It's very good to be here.
Many people have sat where you've sat before, and they've all survived the hot desk. But I'm going to be honest, it is a bit of a grilling. Are you prepared?
Is it really?
It is. Sorry, did I not tell you that beforehand?
Oh, I'm almost blushing right now.
That's good. That's good. I mean, the lights are getting hotter.
I will probably blush a lot.
Okay.
I blush a lot.
Do you?
Yeah.
Are you one of those people that...
Just so you know.
You can't hide your feelings at all. No. But you're laughing, so far so good. Congratulations on all your success so far. Lush Life is the song for me at the moment. I'm not even going to lie, like on a dance floor, that's my thing.
Yay!
Yeah, so can we listen to it now, actually? Let's just have a little watch now, just to kind of get us in the groove. This is Lush Life. I live my day as if it was the last. Live my day as if it was no past. Doing it all night, all summer. Doing it the way I wanna. Yeah, I'ma dance my heart out till the dawn. But I won't be done when morning comes. Doing it all night, all summer. Gonna spend it like no other. Let's just talk about Lush Life because it's such an incredible song. Did you know that this would be the one that would create that kind of international hit?
I know the UK is very good at dance music and like groovy.
We just like getting our dance
you
on.
You sure do.
Mm-hmm.
So, Lush Life is a fun pop song that it's just very fun to dance to.
In the UK, we all know who you are, but we haven't had the album yet, which is out in June.
Yeah, in June.
So is it finished or is it still in the
making? Not really. I'm going back to LA the last trip before the album. I guess I'm done. If I want it to be done, I'm done. But I want to make it a little bit better.
Okay, I want to get to know you a little bit better. This is the first time I've ever met you. Yep. So I want you to describe your music style in a color. If you had to pick one color. I told you I would get trippy.
maybe pink, because I kind of associate that with pop.
If you could describe your music style in an emoji. Are you into, do you use emojis?
I use some emojis.
You're overusing them.
I don't overuse. I have my favorites.
Okay, what's your favorite one? Oh, you're actually going to do it. I was like, she's not replying to the question. Oh, no, you're, okay, yeah, this one. Do it again.
I look exactly like it.
I like this one.
Oh, really?
Yeah, it's just kind of...
Is this the monkey?
Yeah, this...
Mm-hmm. Oh, I hate that one.
Oh. Well, remind me never to text you that. If you could describe your music style in a noise.
Should I sing it? Should
I do
it?
I mean, you're a singer, so... Do... Oh, that's really nice.
Yeah.
I won't do it back. What three words would your mom use to describe you?
She would probably say stubborn.
Okay.
And sassy.
Sassy.
Well, that's like a kind of nice word for being cocky, isn't it?
Yeah, cocky, but a little bit sass. Sassy.
And...
Did you say something nice about you as well?
Yeah. Well, maybe energetic. Yeah.
Okay. So Harry Styles and Katy Perry both tweeted you.
Yeah.
What did they say?
I think Harry Styles said something about he really liked my video for a weak heart. My mom woke me up. She was like, I got a call. Someone told me a Harry guy tweeted you.
Harry?
And I'm so bad at waking up. But when I heard that, I was like, Harry Styles? Do you mean Harry Styles? Yeah, I don't know. Some hairy guy.
I love your mother.
So that was that. And I think Katie tweeted that she really liked my song. She was not me.
Oh, who have you met that's left you most starstruck? Because you've met so many people now.
Beyonce.
So what do you say when you meet Beyonce? Because
First of all, I've been really trying to hide my left hand because I've broken my nail. But if I'm about to talk about Beyonce, I have to use both hands.
Okay, use both hands. And you know what? It doesn't matter.
So basically, now you know. Okay. No, I met her back in 2013. 29th of May.
What hour? How many minutes past the hour?
It was after her Mrs. Carter World Tour in Stockholm. And it was just really cool. I touched the stage. I was so close. I was in the beehive thing, right?
Yeah.
And I just cried the whole time. I just cried and cried and cried.
I love that you're really holding yourself together and being really cool in this situation.
Yeah. I just cried and cried. And then they took me and my sister backstage. Mm-hmm. And I go into the room, I see Beyonce, and I lose it. I lose it. God. I lay down on the floor.
No, you didn't.
Yeah, I did.
Oh, wow.
No shame.
I'm laying down on the floor
like a little meatball. Oh. You know, like a little Swedish meatball.
We've killed this girl.
And I'm like, I'm crying so hard, and then I like stand up and I'm like, oh my gosh, I can't believe it. And you know, she's like, hi, nice to meet you, I'm Beyonce.
And you're like, who's Beyonce?
I'm like, she's like, oh my, you're the girl in the front crying all the time. Like, that's me.
She knew who you were.
Yeah, she saw me because I was in the front with like a few other people.
Have you had that situation the other way around though, when you've got your fans come up to you and they're so starstruck?
Yeah.
It kind of lets you understand the situation.
But it's so hard because I'm like, I'm not Beyonce. No, why are you crying? It's really hard.
But you are Beyonce to someone else because it's...
And that's crazy. Yeah. You know, that's really crazy.
Okay, we're going to play a little game.
Okay, that's cool.
It's called call, text, or eject. So you wake up one morning.
Yeah.
Your phone's on silent.
Yeah.
Three missed calls. Yeah. All from three artists calling you directly because that's what they do. They don't go through the label. Uh-huh. And they all want to work with you.
Oh, wow.
But you're just so busy. You have so much on at the moment.
Right.
So busy. So one of them you can call back, which means you are definitely collaborating with.
Yeah.
The second one you're going to text back, which means it's not going to happen right now, maybe down the line. Yeah. The other one, don't have time for this. You've got too much going on. So here are the three people. Adele.
Mm.
Rihanna.
Mm.
Taylor Swift. We'll start with call back. Who are you calling back?
I love Rihanna and Adele.
So?
I'm going to call back Adele.
And then who are you texting back?
Rihanna.
And then you're...
Sorry, Taylor.
Do you know what? I played this game beforehand with my producer and I said, that's what you were going to say. And I hadn't even met you then. What? Did we even put any money on it? Next time. Okay, one thing left that every artist does.
Okay.
Now, a lot of people have already signed the deck.
Mm, so I see that.
You can either write on top of someone you don't like as well.
Oh, wow.
Just like, you know.
Is Chris Brown here?
Or you can just find a little space.
Okay.
But you can write anything you want. You can draw a picture.
I'm gonna put it right here. Alright, yeah.
Thank you very much for surviving the hot test, and you're welcome back anytime.
Thank you, that was fun.